The rich man tells his children the importance of money. We discuss money with our children. They must understand that that trouser you wear costs money. They must understand we don't exonerate them from the discussion of money. Teach your brothers, your juniors about money. Let them hold the money in their hand. Let them feel it. If your father is not talking to you about money, you have a phone or an ability to go online. Go and write, what is money? Read it, study it, eat it, you become it. A poor man will never talk to his child about money. When the child is asking me, Daddy, how much did you pay for the house? Let me tell you the difference between a poor man and a rich man. Ask your father, how much did you pay for the house? He will ask you, are you going to pay it? That's a poor man. A rich man will tell you, bro, it cost me 4.5 million. He wants to drill it into your head that there's a cost for you sleeping in this house. Whenever I travel anywhere, my son holds the money. He's the one that accounts for it. Because tomorrow, if I'm not there, how will he survive with the money? My daughter is there. Same thing. I trust them with my life. Next slide. Number two, I tell them the difference between an asset and a liability. Asset, liability. What is an asset? An asset is anything that brings money to you. Liability is anything that takes money from you. I expect that today, somebody will go to MTN and tell them, MTN, how can I make money helping you in MTN? MTN will tell you, upgrade somebody to 4G network. They'll give you 100 naira. By the time you do 10 people in a day, you have 30,000 naira in a month. It's not your money, just helping them. They'll give you a short code and you do it. Somebody should walk to farm milk. Farm milk, what can I do? Is it okay? Show people how to buy farm milk or something. Find out, follow the money. Don't let an opportunity to ask about money pass you by. You need to be able to talk to them about how money is made. You need to give them insight into how much their school fees is. Help them to understand how much you spend on them so that they too can appreciate it and know what budgeting is all about. How much do you spend to put food in the house? Let them know. They have an idea, they know. Because tomorrow when their life starts or when they go alone, they should be able to budget for themselves. I can't throw my children into the place without teaching them about money. I can't. I sent my daughter to Dubai. That trip she went to Dubai, I gave her $200. That is 60,000 naira to go to Dubai because I knew that it would have to spend money. Unknown to me, she came back, she bought gift for everybody in the house. Everybody. She was able to calculate how much would I spend for daddy? How much would I spend for mommy? She looked at me and said, daddy, only 500 naira is enough for daddy. Only 500 naira. Mommy, maybe 2,000 naira, but daddy, 500 naira. Daddy has money, but mommy doesn't have money. Imagine that kind of thing. Now, she went and bought for everybody in the house. I was so excited that she was able to manage that money. She came back and told me that a father gave his son $6,000. $6,000, 3 million naira for 10 days. I fear for rich people because if a rich man doesn't train his child about money, when he dies, the children will waste that money. Next slide. You need to show yourself the different ways of making money. There are four ways of making money. One, as an employee, whereby you work for money. Number two, as a self-employed, yes, you can do the business. Some of you can do hair. Tell your auntie, if you are doing your hair, auntie, you pay me 1,000 naira. Charge them. God gave you the gift. Don't do it for free. Self-employed. The third one is owning a business, owning a system. And then the fourth one is an investor. Investor. The picture you see there is Obama's daughter. When Obama was president, he sent his daughter to go and work in a fast food restaurant selling buns and sugar. They didn't tell her to go and live in Dubai. She had to go and learn to work. My children go to learn to work because you must learn how you make money working. But I also teach them how to do business. A poor man will only teach his child how to go and get a job. There are other ways of making money. In the Garden of Eden, there were four rivers entering the garden. Four. It betook God four rivers to water the garden. You cannot be alive and tell me you only need one source of income. If you have only one source of income, you're a poor man. Develop habits that will make you well. Show your children the price they need to pay. In the morning, I spend an hour listening to YouTube on how to become better. My children see me doing that. Your children do not do what you tell them to do. They do what they see you do. If you don't read, they won't read. Whatever your father does, that's what he does. That's what you do. And I encourage you to go and get the book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. You can find it for 1,000 naira. Invest in yourself. Rich Dad, Poor Dad, Robert Kiyosaki. No one owes you anything. Let me drum it into your ear. Your father does not owe you anything. You will find that one out very soon. Your mother does not owe you anything. You owe yourself everything. It is your responsibility to start thinking, how do I make it? When you came to this world, you cried for yourself. You owe yourself. Learn to develop social skills. Learn to be able to relate with people. Learn to be able to talk with people. Learn to be able to influence people. You must learn social and influential skills. That's what leadership is all about. Because when you do that, it becomes the order of the day. And as you do that, begin to ask yourself, where can I market? Where can I push my skills to? My name is Ubon King and I'm just your boy.